Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Eclipse IDE, that is Eclipse IDE version 2024-12 on a Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily start working on your Java projects using Eclipse IDE. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'll definitely going to help you. So now to install Eclipse IDE, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and then you need to search over here Eclipse IDE and hit enter. So that's going to show you this eclipseide.org as your first search result. So you need to click on this Eclipse IDE, that is this Eclipse Foundation, and it's going to redirect to the official site of eclipseide.org. So this link I'm going to provide right in your description. Once when you are here, you will see that our Eclipse IDE is available, the latest version, that is 2024.1. So when you click on this download button, it's going to redirect to this Eclipse Foundation page. Here you can see that at the time of making of this video, version 2024-12 is available to download. So here if you scroll down, you can see that it is available for Java and web developers, the enterprise version. Then this is in Eclipse IDE for only Java developers. Then it is also available for C and C++. Right, so all these different things you can see. So if you scroll down more, you'll see that it is also available for even PHP. So now, depending upon what language you'd like to use for Eclipse, you can always, you know, choose all that. So for now, I'm going to choose for Java. So I'll scroll to top. So here, depending upon what operating system you use, like Linux, macOS or Windows, these are all links available. So for Windows, I'll just simply click on this download button and it immediately it's going to redirect to this Eclipse Foundation page, and here we have a download button. So when you click on this download button, it's going to show you thank you for your download and your Eclipse is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that same Eclipse IDE GRE is rightly downloaded over here. And the file size is just 162 MB. So to install, you need to just simply double click on the installer and it's going to show you this Eclipse installer. So let's minimize our download directory and it's going to slowly show you this Eclipse installer page. So again, as I have told you that it's available for Java, Java Enterprise, C, C++, PHP and all these different languages. So you can always, you know, click on all these different links to proceed, you know, installing Eclipse IDE for that specific purpose. Here in this video, I'm going to use Eclipse IDE for Java developers. So I'll just simply click on this first one and there you go. So you can see that our Eclipse IDE for Java developer installation wizard is rightly open. So here it's going to use the latest version of Java, which is 23.2.1 at the time I'm making of this video. So this is the latest version of Java now. If you want to install a little bit downgraded version of Java, that is GRE version 21, so that also you can do. You need to just simply select this drop down and you need to select that. I'll use 23, so I'll select that, and this is where our Eclipse IDE is going to be installed. Everything is fine, hit install. So this will show license agreement. Always read this, click on accept now, and our installation is rightly began. So you need to have active internet connection as it's going to also install Java along with Eclipse IDE. So you need to have active internet connection. It's going to fetch all the files from internet and then going to install it. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you please to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of videos, and in future I am also planning to post a detailed tutorial on Java, PHP and all that. Alright, so that's why I request you please to subscribe Geeky Syntax channel. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So here let's wait for a couple of minutes. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our Eclipse IDE for Java developers is rightly installed. We have our launch button now, so you can just simply click on this launch button to start launching our Eclipse IDE. We also have a desktop shortcut over here, so you can also double click on it to launch Eclipse IDE from there as well. So this is where our all Eclipse folder or Eclipse projects going to be created. I'll keep this default and click on launch. So our Eclipse is rightly launched over here. Let's maximize it. So this is the interface of our Eclipse IDE. You can click on cancel over here. So this is our sponsored page. You can always, you know, donate some amount to them because they really developed a very good product. So here let's write simple Java program. So close this welcome note and just simply go to file and hover over new to create a Java project. So we are going to create a Hello World Java project over here. So we'll just simply give our project name as Hello World, and it could use latest version of Java, which is 23. So we're going to also uncheck this Java module as it's going to be a very simple Java project. So we're not going to dive into module and all for this video. So I'll keep it simple. Hello World, latest version of Java 23, and click on finish. So a Hello World Java project is rightly created. You can always expand this. You will see a SRC folder. Just simply right click and hover over new and create a new class file over here. So let's give the class name as Hello World itself. And we are going to also check this public static void main as it's going to be a main method. So just after that, click on finish. So immediately it's going to create a Hello World.java file. It is also rightly opened over here. And here is our main method. So here let's print something. So something like system.out.println. And within our bracket, let's print something like Hello World. Alright, so just write something like this and click on save all and click on this run button. So immediately we'll see that it is right to start building and it's going to show you the output Hello World on our console. So in this way you can easily install Eclipse IDE and you can start working on your Java projects that probably you have got from your school or college. So that's how you install Eclipse IDE. Don't forget to subscribe to our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting a lot of videos. Recently I posted some videos on WordPress and all. So you can also follow that video as well. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.